Hi there, this is a video series of Google Calendar API integration. In this video, we are going to see how to update event of the Google Calendar using Google Calendar API. In the last video, we have seen how to get a single event using Event ID and how to get all events from the Google Calendar using Google Calendar API. So if you haven't watched the video yet, the link is in the description, please go and check out. For this video, we will walk through the API documentation, then quickly jump into the code. Before we start the video, I would like to request you to watch the video completely so that you will have proper concept. So let's get started. To update the event, we have to make the patch request to the Event API endpoint, in which we have to pass the calendar ID and the event ID in the path parameter. So in the calendar ID, we can pass primary keyword, and in the event ID, we have to pass the ID of the event which we wanted to update. In this also, we have some query parameter which are again optional. So please go through them and try by your own. The scopes required for this API is at least one of them. So we already have these scopes. So in the request body, we have to pass the updated event model. So once the request is successful, we will be getting OK as the status code. And in the response body, we will be getting the updated event. So let's see how we can make the HTTP request. So to update the event, we have to make the patch request to the Event API endpoint, in which we have to pass the query parameter as key, whose value will be our API key. And in the header, we have to pass following keys: authorization, whose value will be bearer, and access token separated with the space; accept, whose value will be application/json; content type, whose value will be again application/json. And in the request body, we will be passing the updated meeting model. So let's jump into the code now. So this is a continuation video of this series, so please go and check out the previous videos to understand the code flow properly. So in the all events, I have added a link called edit. If we click edit, it will navigate us to the update event action in the calendar event controller with the meeting ID as the parameter. So let's see calendar event controller. So in this, we have update event action which is having one parameter. So in this action, we are simply getting the event using the event ID and returning it to the update event view. So here we are reading the tokens from the token file, and then we are creating a request. And we are adding the query parameter having key, whose value will be the API key. And we are adding the header with following keys. One is authorization, whose value will be bearer and access token separated with space. And other will be accept, whose value will be application/json. Then we are making the get request to the event API endpoint. So once the request is successful, we will be getting status code as OK. And then we are converting the response to our event model, and then we are sending it to the view. So let's see the update view. It is a simple form which will give us the pre-populated data of the event. If you update the data and submit, then it will navigate us to the update event with the identifier of the event. So let's see the other update event method. So we have the other update event method which has two parameters. One is identifier and other is the calendar event. So this is the updated event model. So in this method, we are updating the event. So here we are reading the tokens from the token file. We are creating a request, and then we are converting the start date time and end date time to the RFC 3339 format. And then we are adding the query parameter with key whose value will be API key. And we are adding the following headers: authorization, whose value will be bearer and access token separated with space; accept, whose value is application/json; content type, whose value is application/json. And we are adding the updated event model in the request body. Then we are making the patch request to the event API endpoint. If the request is successful, we will be getting the status code as OK, and we are navigating back to the all events. So let's run and check. So our application is running now. Let's see all events now. So we can see edit link beside each event. So I can edit now. So let's click edit for this event. So I can see the prefilled form here. So this is the summary of the event which I wanted to edit. this is the description and this is the time. So one thing is to be noted here is the time which we get from the API call, it will be in the 24 hour format. But in our application, we are sending start date time and end date time in the 12 hour format. So let's update. This event is from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. So let's change it from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. and let's submit. So now we can see our event has been updated successfully. Let's open the calendar and see either it is being updated in the calendar or not. So here I have one event from 12 to 1 p.m. Title is testing event. So let's change the title once and then check. Let's update and check this. So we can see our event has been updated and its title is testing event updated. So this is how we update the event in the Google Calendar using Google Calendar API. So that is it for the video, guys. Hope you like the video. In the next video, we will see how to delete the event in the Google Calendar. If you have any doubt, please do let me know in the comment section. And please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.